Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss the assumptions of molecular orbital theory. In last lecture we have discussed about basics related to MOT, okay, what are the diagrams, which orbitals are called as A1g, T1u and T2g always a eg orbitals, okay. In today's lecture we are going to discuss how many orbitals can take part in sigma bonding orbitals, how many orbitals can take part in a pi bonding orbitals. So one by one we will see the assumption. Let us see first assumption. In the formation of MOT, well, in a central metal ion, there are totally 9 orbitals. Which can be classified as first are for formation of sigma bond with ligand and metal ion and for formation of pi bond with a ligand and central metal ion. Okay. Now the question arises, how many orbitals and which orbitals? Okay. For the formation of sigma bond, we are taking part in a orbitals such as 3D, 4S and 4P orbitals. Okay. Going in consideration. Orbitals. Already you know that the subshell orbitals are in 3D. How many total subshell orbitals? That is, there are 5 orbitals. In 4s, there is only 1 orbital. Okay. And in 4p, there are 3 subshell orbitals. Okay. Now, in 3D, which are the classifications? See here. First is EG and second is T2g. But in between these two types of orbitals, there is a basic difference. Okay. What is the basic difference here? The orbitals which are coordinated along the axis and the orbitals which are coordinated between the axis. T2g orbitals coordinated between the axis. Therefore, they can form the pi bond. Which bond? That is the pi bond. Whatever may be the remaining one, that is the EG orbitals. EG orbitals are located along the axis. Therefore, they can take part in a formation of sigma bond with a central metal ion. Therefore, here, out of the 9 orbitals, totally 6 orbitals. Orbitals are used in formation of sigma bonding orbital with a central metal ion. And remaining 3, what is the remaining 3? That is the T2g orbitals. Which are the T2g orbitals? Here, that is dxy, dyz and dxz. They are used for formation of a pi bond with a central metal ion with its ligand group symmetry. Okay, now. This is the first assumption. Now we will see the second assumption. See here. In a second assumption, which is a compulsory one, that is, each ligand must have at least one sigma bonding orbital. That is, each ligand must have at least one sigma bonding orbital. Now, what is the third third assumption is of related with a ligands. Here, the ligands are constructed. Constructed in such a way that they combine with themselves to form a new set of ligand group orbitals or symmetry orbitals in short it is called as LGOs. Okay, thus there is formation of ligand group orbitals which can possess same symmetry, okay, for the bonding purpose. Okay, now the ligands are constructed to form a sigma bond with how many orbitals? Already we have seen 6 orbitals as follows. Which are the 6 orbitals? See here. Now, here the statement is very important one, that is ligands are constructed in such a way that to form a sigma bond with a 6 orbitals. Which are the 6 orbitals? Again, I am going to discuss you. It is first is 3D orbitals, second is 4s orbital, and again third is 4p orbital. 3D is of eg orbitals, 4s orbitals, and 4p orbital. Total is equal to 6 orbitals. Okay. Now, these orbitals are constructed in such a way that first we have to write the 4s orbital. According to our classical group theory, the designation for 4s that is equal to A1g. Okay. 4p orbital for T1u. And for eg as it is. Okay. That is 1, this is. This is of 3 and this is of 2 orbitals. Total is equal to 6 orbitals. How they are constructed? The mathematical form is as follows. First we are going to see here, that is A1G. A1G is equal to A dash G summation 1 upon root 6 into. This is symmetrical orbital. Therefore, coordinate axis we have to take the same sigma x. Plus sigma of minus x, sigma of y, plus sigma of minus y, plus sigma of z, plus sigma of minus z. Okay, now, what is the remaining orbital? That is T1u. T1u is the sum of which, that is T1u of here px, T1u of py, and T1u of pz. Whatever may be the notation for px, py and pz, we have to write here as follows. See here, t1u of px, that is t1u of px is equal to summation of px is equal to 1 upon root 2 into bracket for x axis, that is sigma x minus sigma of y. Okay, for py, summation of py is equal to like this. That is equal to 1 upon root 2 summation of y, sigma y minus of minus y. Okay. And so, pz is equal to 1 upon root 2, that is equal to sigma of z orbital minus sigma of minus z. And these are combinedly known as T1 U. Okay, that is T1 U. Okay, now what is the remaining one? That is the EG. EG of which orbitals? That is dx square minus y square and dz square. What is the mathematical form? See here. Eg orbitals. Eg of which kinds? That is equal to dx square minus y square and dz square. This is located along the axis. The axis. Okay. Now, here Eg is equal to summation of dx square minus y square. Eg dash is equal to, okay, 1 upon 2 x square minus y square. Therefore, sigma x plus sigma minus x minus sigma y minus log minus y. Okay, here as like this. Now, Eg of another orbital is equal to summation of dz square. Okay, what is this? Dz square means that is equal to 1 upon root 12. Okay, here z square, therefore 2 into sigma z plus 2 into sigma of minus z minus sigma of x minus sigma of y minus sigma of minus x, here, sorry, sigma of y minus sigma of minus y. Thus, this is the construction of LGOs according to the symmetry orbital. This is the mathematical form. This form is derived from the group theory. Okay. Now, the last assumption, last two assumptions are here. The last assumptions, that is fourth assumption, last but not here. Now, the formation of bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital. How it is takes place? The central metal ion metal orbital combines with matching group symmetry orbitals of which central metal ion is of, that is A1G, for example, A1G orbital combines with matching group symmetry of A1G combines with A1G of LGOs with same symmetry to form one bonding molecular orbital, that is, in short, it is called as BMO, and one antibonding molecular orbital, that is ABMO. This is the shortcut. Okay. Now, the central metal orbital combines with matching group symmetry orbitals of, for example, here A1G combines with which orbital? A1G of ligand group orbitals to form one bonding molecular orbital and another orbital. Again, we have taken the example of which, that is, second is of T1U of metal ion orbital combines with T1U of dash of ligand group orbitals orbitals of same symmetry. Same symmetry to form one bonding molecular orbital and one antibonding molecular orbital. Okay, now here one point should be noted, that it is the orbitals are combined with symmetry group orbitals in such a way that there is formation of one bonding and one antibonding. Bonding orbital molecular orbital possess the lower energy, that of antibonding molecular orbital possess the higher energy. Antibonding molecular orbital can be represented by using dash over the orbital or a star mark. Okay, already you know this concept. Now the last one assumption is related with a T2G orbital. What is these are the bonding sigma orbitals. Now what is the assumption related to non-bonding, that is remaining of a T2G orbitals? See here, if the complex possess T2G orbitals, okay, orbitals along with possess T2G orbitals along with sigma bonding orbital, then what happens here? Here, T2G orbitals combines with symmetry group ligands of T2G dash to form pi bond along with a sigma bond. Okay, now what is the meaning of this? If the complex contains the pi orbitals, that is the T2G orbital. T2G orbitals are nothing but the formation of a pi orbital along with the sigma bonding orbital. At that time, what happens? T2G orbital combines with a symmetry group ligands of T2G, and there is formation of a pi bond. Here, these T2G orbitals overlaps with symmetrical T2G ligand group orbitals. Okay, and thus there is formation of a pi bond. Thus, there are totally five main assumptions which are used to express the molecular orbital diagram for suitable complex. These assumptions are totally applied in only case of octahedral complex. Now, in next lecture, we are going to see what is the diagrammatic representation of an octahedral complex using the molecular orbital theory. One should know the orbitals which are taking part in a sigma bonding orbital. That is, there are six orbitals. Which are these six orbitals? First is 4s, 3d, 4s and 4p. 4p of which only eg orbitals, that is of 3d is of eg orbitals of 2 orbitals, 4s is a 1 orbital and 4p of its 3 orbitals. Total are 6 orbitals. 6 orbitals can take part in a bonding molecular orbital fashion with a octahedral complex. And while the remaining 3 orbitals which are taking part in a formation of a non-bonding molecular orbital, that is remains, they are used for only formation of a pi bonding along with a sigma bonding molecular orbital. I hope that all of you understand these assumptions of MOT of octahedral complex very clearly. If any are doubts, please ask me on the group and complete your difficulties. Okay, thank you.